Hi, welcome back. This is Rakesh Naik. Today we are going to discuss about NP-Completeness of Vertex Cover Problem. But before we start, a small information I'd like to share. In this channel, we produce every video in two different languages, Hindi as well as in English, so that you can watch the video in your preferred language. You can identify the video from its thumbnail. Right now you are watching it in English, and if you want to watch it in Hindi, the link given in the description. And if you have not yet subscribed, kindly subscribe and press the bell icon so that you will get all the updates from this channel. So let us start. NP completeness of vertex cover problem. Let us first try to understand what is a vertex cover problem. A vertex cover problem of a graph is a set of vertices that touches every edge in the graph. It means if a graph is given and which is represented in the form of a set of vertices and set of edges, then I'll take a subset VC, subset or equal to the set of vertices, such that if AB belongs to E, that is a set of edge, then either A belongs to V or B belongs to V or both A and B belongs to V. Let us see an example here. For this particular graph, if I choose vertex A, then edge 1, 2, edge 1, 4 and edge 1, 3 is covered. If I choose vertex 3, then edge 1, 3, edge 2, 3, edge 4, 3 and edge 5, 3 are covered. Similarly, if I take the vertex 4, then edge 2, 4 and edge 5, 4 are covered. It means by choosing vertex 1, 3 and 4, all the edges of this particular graph is covered. So as per the definition, the vertex cover of the graph GVE is a subset VC. So in the vertex set V, I'm having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 vertices. But in the subset VC, I'm having vertices 1, 3 and 4. So VC is a subset or equal to V. And if AB belongs to E, that is the set of edges in the graph, then either vertex A belongs to VC or B belongs to VC or both A and B belongs to VC. That can be verified from this particular graph. So before trying to prove the vertex cover problem, let us try to understand what is reduction. Reduction is very important when we are proving either NP complete or NP hard of any particular problem. So here, if problem B is given and I want to prove that whether this particular problem is NP hard or NP complete, then I have to choose a known problem, that is A, and I have to reduce it to B. And this reduction is supposed to be done in polynomial time. Then what I can say, if A and B are two problems and A is reduced to problem B, if and only if there is a way to solve A by deterministic algorithm that solve B in polynomial time. So if problem A is reducible to problem B, then it is denoted by this particular symbol. Now let us try to see the properties of reduction. If A is reducible to B and B can be solved in polynomial time, then A also can be solved in polynomial time. The second property is if A is not in P, it means problem A is not solvable in polynomial time, it implies B cannot be solved in polynomial time. Let us see the reduction in NP complete. So if A and B are two languages and A is reducible to B in polynomial time, then B is NP hard. And if problem B is NP problem, then B is NP complete. So let us try to see what are the steps involved in showing NP completeness of any particular problem. So the first step is prove that B is a NP problem. The second step is select a NP complete language or a problem, that is problem A. The third step is construct a function F that maps the member of A to the member of B. And the third step is so that X is in A if and only if F of X is in B. And the last step is so that this F can be computed in polynomial time. Now let us try to prove the NP completeness of vertex cover problem. It means the two things that I have to do is I have to show vertex cover is a problem in NP. And second thing is vertex cover problem is NP hard. If these two things I can show that vertex cover problem is NP complete. Now I want to show that vertex cover problem is an NP. So let us try to first recall what is a NP problem. A problem which cannot be solved in polynomial time but can be verified in polynomial time is known as NP problem or non-deterministic polynomial problem. So here the set of vertices VC is vertex cover of G, that is VE. It means if vertex cover contains k number of elements, then we can check by order of number of vertices plus number of order time. That will be the vertex cover VC of the graph G. So for each vertex belongs to VC, remove all the incident edges and check all the edges are removed from G. So that is how we can show the vertex cover problem is NP. Now let us show a vertex cover problem is NP hard. And to show the vertex cover problem is NP hard, we need to see one more problem which is a known problem. So let us take a clique problem. If you have not seen the video on NP completeness of clique problem, kindly follow the link given above and see it. We'll take the clique problem and we'll try to reduce it to vertex cover problem. It means that we'll take the instance of clique and we will produce a graph that is GVE and an integer k such that and G has a maximum clique of k if and only if G bar has vertex cover of size number of vertices minus k. What is G bar? G bar is nothing but the complement of the graph. To recall the complement of the graph, let us say if this is a graph given, the complement will be this one. To check it, you can see if I merge these two graphs, this will be a complete graph. So I can say that G is complement of G bar and vice versa. So complement of the graph G dash VE dash of graph GVE is a graph where E dash is set of vertices, UV belongs to G, where UV doesn't belongs to G bar, or you can say union of GVE and G bar VE bar is a complete graph. So if GVE is a graph given to me and in that graph number of vertices are n with clique size of k, then I have to reduce this problem in polynomial time to a graph G dash VE dash with vertex cover of number of vertices in this graph V minus k, that is the clique. In this graph we are having number of vertices as 5 with maximum clique as 4. If you remember, this is a complete subgraph with 4 vertices. So for this particular graph, I'll get a vertex cover, that is number of vertices minus clique, that is 5 minus 4, that is 1. So here in this graph, I'm getting a vertex cover of. Let us try to show if G has a clique with vertices V dash with size K, then we can show that then G has vertex cover of number of vertices minus K. Now let us say if AB belongs to E, the main graph, then AB will not belongs to E dash, the complement of the H. If AB belongs to E dash, then at least A or B will not belongs to be in V dash. It means every pair V dash is connected by an H in E. This implies at least one of either A or B is in V minus V dash. This implies H AB is a vertex cover by V minus V dash. Let us take two graphs here. Here is a graph. In this graph, we are having V as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. V dash, the clique, having vertex 1, 2, 3 and 4. And we can identify that V minus V dash will be having vertex 5 only. So we are showing the vertex cover. So the H here, if I am taking an H, AB belongs to E, let us say vertex 1, 3 belongs to E. It means vertex 1, 3 is not there in E dash. And if AB belongs to E dash, if 1, 5 belongs to E dash, then either at least A or B doesn't belong to V dash. So either vertex A or vertex 5 will not be an edge within this clique. This condition holds because of every connected graph having edge between them. So it means what? At least one of A or B is in B minus V'. This is evident from this particular graph. It means edge AB is covered by this vertex V minus V'. So this is one side of the proof. We need to prove the other also. It means what? If the vertex size of a graph is number of vertices minus K, then the clique size will be having size K. Thank you for watching this video till the end. Keep watching, keep learning. And if you like the video, kindly share among your friends, give thumbs up. We'll win one more video. Till then, take care.